Hi, this is Ryan. This is where I review the videos and try to give people a better understanding of how I got the translations. I hope you find it useful. I think people will find this useful, especially those who just want to listen to these videos without watching the captions come up, and it'll help you to understand them better as well if you do that. Please excuse the noise in the background because I've got two birds that a lot of like to play around and make a lot of noise. So if you hear a blackbird call and a budgie talking, you'll know where it's coming from. So I want to start with this. This is Victor's A Spiritual Body, and it was in presentation 3, and it's one of my favorites. He says some very interesting things here, and you'll find at the end of this has some pretty interesting reverse communications from myself and my ex-wife as well. So let's get started with this one. Let's go back to the beginning here. So the forward part is coming here. So he says he'd like to breed a culture. He just said he'd like to, he might breed a culture with the videos that you will see. Let's go back and just replay that again. Or yes, I might breed a culture with the videos that you'll see. That's kind of a joke as well, because I've heard the expression before, breeding a culture is like having number two, and budgies are known for their little poos all over the place. So I think Victor was just throwing a little bit of humor in that statement right there. Well, let's go on from there. I think you're going to be hearing part of the reverse next, or we'll see. Actually, that was forward, and he says, like a jury, are we supposed to be Bosch like their budgie? And what he's saying here is Bosch means like, it's not a good word, like, it's not intelligent. Like, most people think budgies just talk and they're not intelligent. And so he's saying, if there was a jury and looked at this, they would think that all budgies are supposed to be non-intelligent. Let's go back over and hear that part again. He starts off with like a jury, and he says that kind of fast. And then he just said, if they started showing this dialogue, they'd have to enlist their doctors. In other words, if a jury was watching this and they started believing that a budgie was talking like this, they would probably be thinking that they'd have to enlist their doctor or their psychiatrist, because it's not possible. Because most people would think it's not possible. Let's hear that part again. So there was a combination of both forward and reverse in that one. Let's go on to the next part. He says, you see, they tend to call me fake here. And that's happened quite a bit in the past, that people, even the people that can hear a lot of what he's saying, say it can't be real, that it's somehow faked or something like that. So if they don't admit that they can hear it, they either don't admit they can hear it, or then if they do hear it, they say it's fake. To enlist their doctors, he said at that last part. And this next part is kind of interesting. He talks about my emotions here. He said, every emotion Ryan had sure had reason. And there were a lot of times that I would try and introduce this to forums and that, and I'd get a lot of people, you know, making bad comments or saying things, you know, trying to discredit it. And there was a point where, you know, when I tried to introduce it and I had that happen to me, that I would get discouraged and I'd quit for a while. But and I'd have to kind of regroup even though I wasn't active in actually going out there and trying to promote it, I was still doing the translations. So well, let's continue on there again, see if we can hear that again. So he said, every emotion Ryan had sure had reason. And then he says, that's really tough here. Or he could have said, it's really tough here. You can hear the TV talking in the background there. Now, this is interesting because the angels can even, or the spiritual and the spiritual connection can even change what the TV is communicating as well. And you'll see that happen throughout some of the videos. That in reverse, the connection is so strong that it even affects the with the television and anything else that comes in reverse. Now that was so faint you might not hear it, but first he says, how's your beer? Now he's making kind of a slight towards, you know, I would sit and I would have a beer once in a while when my emotions were running high or something like that and I was stressed. And so he says, how's your beer? And then you can hear the TV in the background. If you listen really closely, you might have to crank it up a bit when you do this one, but the TV set, is saying something here in reverse. And originally I thought he said we're with them, but now he's talking about how groups argued and still staying on the same topic. They argued with him. I'll say play that again. So underneath, right down here, I thought he said we are with him, but he could be saying, I'm pretty sure he's saying they argued with him. And then he said, and Ryan shall be complete when they come with some belief. We'll try and play that again. And that belief was really hard to understand. And then he says, but first you're going to have to, I think he says, come with, let's hear what he says in this. And then he said, but first you're going to believe the truth. We'll play that again. Now that was pretty cool. That was all in reverse. He says, but first, play that again. I can't remember exactly what he said, but we'll play that through again. He says, soon you will know for sure how to find angels and begin talking with heaven. He says, the toast goes to all them walking around your house. And he's talking about the angels here. Now this part's really interesting. So basically he's saying that we have spirits around us all the time, kind of like on a different, in a different dimension, that are walking around and interacting with us our souls and we don't even know about it. So he says, a toast goes to all them walking around your house stamping out evil. And he says, and we know as you console these souls, so they can, budgies can actually experience these other dimensions, and they're interacting with them on a level that we don't know. He says, don't believe all the concepts that put us at a big war. In other words, he's saying, don't believe and don't fear all these things that people say about spirits, that they're evil and they're working against us. It's actually the other way around. They're working with us, and they're trying to help us in many different ways, like guardian angels.
Look at me, Victor.
He says, we've all been blessed with the spiritual body, and we've been given much to save us from suffering. And then he'll say, by God, from God. And that's fairly clear. I'm going to do don't believe all the concepts again.
Look at me, Victor.
By God was just a little click in his voice, but I could hear him say by God there. And the next part, let's hear the next part here. He said, God can help us to resist all the evil. And that was kind of fast. Maybe I could slow that one down a bit. He just said, I'd like to promise you. We'll play that again.
Look at me.
I'd like to promise you.
Look at me.
Once you know what's belied the truth. He says, so in other words, he's saying he'd like to promise you, once you know what's hiding the truth, you'll find the way to heavens. And then he says, we shall need your love. In other words, we shall need your love in heaven. So once you know the truth, you'll find your way to heaven, because God and the angels need our love there. And you'll have the key. Now that was really quick, because he switched from key to actually so fast it sounded like the same sentence there. And he says, actually all will have the right to come. And you'll have the, he first starts off with, you'll have the key, and actually all will have the right to come. He says, we know that another love you'll find. Let's play that again. He says, we know that another love you'll find will be waiting for you, which is kind of awesome. Relatives, past lives, spirits in your family, people that you've loved in the past that go to heaven will be waiting for you there.
What are you doing under there?
And that's cool when he goes, he puts so much emphasis in that. He goes, oh, be different right now.
What are you doing under there?
And he says, oh, be different right now. You cannot miss it. Now, he's got so much emphasis in that. How can you not want to, you know, go to heaven and be with God when you're getting testimony straight from, you know, a spiritual source telling you what it's like? It's amazing. He says, and then he says, an awesome form of life will be admitting you. Now that's it. So that's our, this awesome form of life could be an angel or our next step in spiritual evolution. And I find that quite amazing as well. So obviously when we die, we evolve to a different form of a physical form, which is quite incredible. And then I say in reverse, and you have no idea, which is kind of cool. And then he says, we have a right to unite the world if they dock here. Play that again. And he says, tread softly. I'm pretty sure I thought it, or I think he said slowly, actually. I changed it to slowly, but he says, tread slowly in this world and you'll hear it. That was in reverse.
Are you an actor on the TV?
Again, it's still in slow motion, so I sound funny.
You want to be an actor?
Excuse me. He says, then he says, your future is happy if you can connect with life's symphony. Let's play that again. And the song is having people in our lives. That's what he does. And then I say, who can evolve in reverse? So this is where I start interacting and finishing his sentences that he's making in forward mode, in reverse, which is, if you think about it, it's impossible. In other words, I would be finishing his sentences before he actually says them. I don't know if you, when you reverse a recording, everything that is said before comes after, and vice versa for the forward mode. So you can't deny that there's something amazing and incredible happening and miraculous happening in here, especially after you listen to some of the last parts of this one. And then I say in reverse, see me emerge, hallelujah. When I heard that, that was quite amazing. I'll play that again.
You're happy, are you? What are you happy about?
So I do a fair amount of talking in this part, and then my ex-wife starts talking to Victor here, and she says some really interesting things in reverse, and you'll hear them in a couple of minutes.
Are you happy, Victor?
Then he just said, "Words free me, as things come out, you shall be free." Let's play that again.
Where's Betty?
That's enough for sure.
And then he just said, "That's enough for sure." I don't know if he's talking about me mentioning Betty or if he's decided he wanted to quit talking. He just wanted to tell me that he's ready to stop talking.
Where's Betty?
Yeah, he was ready to stop and said, "Turn it off." Now this is going to be the reverse of what we just talked about. Excuse me, I got a little bit of a cold. That's why I'm not working on transcription, because I can't. I got a little bit of sinus going on, so probably wouldn't be able to hear as well. So I'm doing these instead. Let's continue on with this. And then he said in reverse, "And I feel all this love."
He'd have to.
And then I say in reverse, "You'd have to." And then this next part in reverse that he says is pretty cool. I'll repeat that last part.
He'd have to.
Then he says, "Do you feel as fuzzy and excited too?" That's so cool.
He'd have to.
That was in reverse. And then my ex-wife in reverse says, "Does anybody really need these dimensions?" And so that's pretty clear. Play that again. And then I say, finally, "We've decided to pray. Are you tired?" I'll play that one more time. Yeah, so that's, like I said, that's one of my favorite ones. It was a little bit choppy. I don't know what happened with the encoding when I changed it to, you know, when I made the video, and I think I tried to fix it, but I was using an older program, and I guess that was causing me some problems. Maybe in the future I'll have time to correct it right, but I hope you enjoyed that, and we'll talk to you with the next one.